Okay, so I realized a couple things after posting some questions to the Minijet boat build page, and basically wondering why the boat seemed to be pulling left. But if you think about like motorcycles, the radius of the tire or the wheel, you really don't have to steer too much. You just lean, and then you let the curvature of the wheel steer you. So the same effect happened with me in this boat, and I just didn't use any common sense. So I had about 25 to 30 pounds worth of tools in the bag. I had the oar right there, and I had maybe like 6 or 7 pounds worth of straps in the side of the boat here, and I was the only one in the boat. So naturally everything was wanting to go on this side, and the heaviest side of the motor is on the driver's side because the supercharger is hanging off of it right there. So that's pretty much the exact reason why it was pulling me to the left while I was driving. So no longer concerned about that. And I posted thinking that maybe my ride plate was the source of the issues. But as you can see, they're level to one another. From the swim deck to the skid plate on the bottom here below. So that's that was good to see. And I know that the swim deck is actually level to the bottom of the intake. So all is well in boat world. But to get started here, we are going to get the through-hole fittings for the electric bilge installed, which the electric bilge is right there. And we're gonna get the pisser or the telltale installed here. So that's just gonna be this 45 degree guy that goes like right there or something. Just so I can easily view that water is passing through my engine and it's not plugged up and not cooling itself. All right, so I'm gonna get started drilling these two holes now, and we'll go from there. The hole drilled in the side of the boat. I'm gonna install the fitting through there, but I do not have any rubber washers that are this size, and I don't plan to remove this anytime soon, and I just am gonna use the Sika Marine. But trying to think of an accurate analogy about what it feels to use this stuff, and the best thing I can come up with is imagine diving into a giant pool of honey and then trying to not be sticky after doing that. That's pretty much the best way to describe using this stuff. All right, I'm gonna get this installed now. So that's installed. And I am pretty proud that I was able to install this without ruining it. Oh, come on. Spoke too soon. I was getting ready to say I was pretty proud that I installed this without ruining every thing that I own. We'll be right back.
All right, so I just went to Pat's house, got the bulkhead and all the aluminum cleaned up, cut up, and sized. So that's the bulkhead and the hatch that is gonna go on the back here. So before I can start sizing any of this up in there and getting templates, I need to remove the seats, I need to remove the fuel cell, get all the wiring out of the way, and then start figuring out how it's gonna go in there. So, all right, get started on that now. Okay, so I have to be pretty gentle because if I so much as fart, the cardboard will fall down. So that's roughly the way I'm gonna have it though. Got the corners all mounted. Got my cardboard aided design, which I stole that from my neighbor Chris. He's been saying that for like the last 5 years. Yeah, it's so that's the template I'm gonna use to cut the aluminum out with. So you can see it's not gonna be fully sealed up, but a buddy from New Zealand mentioned that you're not gonna be able to do this in just one fell swoop, so I'm gonna have to build a couple additional little plates that are gonna go in these areas. And that works out so that I can continue to have my routing for my fuel pump and everything, and then I'll build grommets into there and like a quick access kind of door on this side and maybe something else on the other side. Not sure yet, but yeah, so that's good so far. The only kind of crappy thing about this is the way in which my fuel cell mounts. I basically have to finagle the fuel cell in into the boat and then slide it into the cavity here. But you can see that my my mounts I have set up here. Let me angle this. My mounts I have set up here mimic that of the actual fuel cell mounts with the air conditioning isolator pads and then the server rack rail. So, but it works out nice. It should have enough clearance. All right, I think I'm going to draw this out on the bulkhead piece here and see what it looks like. All right, the cardboard template is exactly the way it needs to be. And I overlaid it onto the 24-inch section of aluminum that was cut out of Pat's yesterday. And I got some extra lines here, but we'll just call that cryptography. So yeah, I will, I'll get this cut out right now with the plasma cutter that Pat let me borrow. Plate of aluminum has been cut to fit the stringers for the notching, like so. And now I just have to get angled aluminum put in place right there so that I can weld it to the bottom of the boat, and then right there so I can weld it to the stringer. Mike and I are gonna get started on that now. All right, so on the back side of this, where it mounts to the bottom of the boat, I'm gonna use angled aluminum to make a tab so that I have more surface area to weld to the actual boat surface on this side, and then on the opposite side, so that it sandwiches itself, I'm gonna do two other plates like this against the stringer. All right, so this is what it's gonna look like. Okay, and then we have our tab on the other side. And then whenever it stands up, something like this. All right, gonna get this fully welded up and then installed in the boat. Okay, have the little lip here for when the engine hatch comes down, it's gonna have something to rest on. So just gotta build that around here, and then it's probably not necessary to do it around the perimeter of it, so just the front. We'll be right back. All right, so that is that appears to be done here. Well, at least the main portion of the bulkhead. I still have to fill in the side pieces here, because those will let a lot of engine noise pass. And got a good bit here done. There's one thing I learned, and not necessarily learned, is probably taught from JDH 104. It's that I need to clean the oxide layer. You can see whenever I did that, the welds end up so much nicer. Whenever you look at that compared to something like this right there, you can see right there it's just kind of like gooped on there, and it doesn't really have consistent penetration. It's very porous. So you definitely have to grind the surface off so that it gets a good penetration. I was still pretty porous with this whole weld here, but I'm pretty happy with it. Got some more parts in. Got the fuel filler neck, which is gonna go right here, or like that, or just like so. And then I have the fuel filler tube. I have the throttle cable that I still need to get set up. That's gonna basically run out the top here into a grommet right there, and then go along the gunnel, and then pop out, and then circle its way down to the throttle body. All right, this is coming along very good. Now all I have to do is take that sheet of aluminum and get a box made out of that square stock or square tube and get it set on top of here. I'll install the seats, but those go on pretty easily. All right, the next video will be throttle cable, filler tube, and maybe finishing the engine hatch. So it might take a while though, because I have other projects going on, like tires for the 335i as I'm getting the wheels powder coated and various other little things. All right, that'll wrap this up. And I need one of these. Something fierce.